My dear students, in the previous class, we discussed Unnikrishnan versus Andhra Pradesh government case. Related to this, basic what we call the fundamental rights. According to that, the court has said that the entire education structure, beginning from Anganwadi, that we call the preschool, Anganwadi education to higher education should be seen from holistic perspective. What do you mean by holistic? Holistic means comprehensive perspective. Supreme Court clearly guides the education must be seen through holistic perspective. As per this decision, all the citizens of the country have the basic right for education. See, education is basic right. It is the part of right to live. See, education is part of right to live. But inequality in opportunities in education is on the rise. What does it mean? Inequality in education opportunity is rising. Still, inequality is there in accessing education. That is, see, rise. This is rising due to various legal issues. There is also rise in inequality due to different economic standards in the access to education. See, inequality in accessing education. In accessing education, still it is there, though there is clear guidelines from Supreme Court regarding Unnikrishnan and Andhra Pradesh government cases, still it is there and it guides education is part of right to life. Though all these measures, still there is inequality in accessing education. Still, the efforts to eradicate unequal opportunities in the field of education are on with the help of constitutional provisions. But if we see and if we go back 100 years or 150 years, the situation is far more better due to constitutional provisions. Now, the lowest above the society are able to get the education. Lowest, some community and means they are into education, the first generation coming to education. Some community in Dakshina Kannada also, that means they are not able to get the education, but now their first generation is coming to education. Okay, this is all about education and inequality. Now we are moving to another inequality that is also very pathetic condition of Indian society, that is gender inequality. Now we are moving to see gender inequality. Gender equality is one of the various social inequalities. There are so many social inequalities there, but gender inequality is also one of the social inequalities, and it gets formed. There is more gender based inequality in access to school education, food and health facility. We know, we say Matru Devo Bhava. We consider mother is great. Since that, we are denying opportunity for woman, girl. We never see she play a vital role in this society, but she is denied. She is our mother, she is our brother, sister, she is our friend. Moreover, a good guide. Even after all these, we are denying opportunity for her. We are denying opportunity to her. So still gender inequality is prevailing in this society. Now let's come to the point, another point. According to National Family Health Survey 4, which was occurred in 2015 and 16, National Family Health Survey 4, which conducted in 2015 and 16, where according to this, the rural women of Karnataka have body mass index, body mass index BMI. It is 24.3, whereas the urban women of Karnataka 16. See, this is rural woman. It's about 24.3 body mass index, whereas the rural urban woman 16.2 urban. This means the women have lesser body mass index. This means the women have lesser body mass index. Now let me explain briefly about BMI. What does BMI mean? BMI means body mass index. Body mass index is a person's weight in kilograms divided by the square height in meters. It is not given in your textbook. You can also see the Google graphic image of body mass index. Once again, let's see what is body mass index. Body mass index is a person's weight in kilograms and divided by the square height in meters. In brief, and an additional question, note down that question: what is the best BMI for women? Doctors consider a healthy for woman to be 18.5. See, doctors consider a healthy for woman to be 18.5 to 24.9. A BMI of 30 or above may indicate obesity, fat. See, the density. Now let's come to the main point. 60.9% of the children between 6 and 56 month. 6 and 56 month have severe anemia. Now we discussed body mass index. And another point is here. 6 to 54 months, the children between 6 to 54 months, sorry, 56 months have severe anemia. What do you mean by anemia? Anemia means a condition in which the blood doesn't have enough healthy red blood cells. The hemoglobin content may have less. That is anemia. Here they are telling 69% of children are suffering from anemia. That is why nowadays government is providing iron contented tablets for children, providing urine. Then 45.2% of the pregnant women suffer from anemia. See, the pregnant woman means, you know, that she is going to give birth to child. If she is suffering from anemia, what would happen for the child? What would happen for the next generation? This is the biggest problem. It means 45.2% of the pregnant women suffer from anemia. What do you mean by anemia? I asked two questions. What is the best BMI for women? And what do you mean by body mass index? And what is anemia? Three questions. Note down three questions. That is for homework and Vidyagama. And In this scenario, the development should include food and nutrition, security to women and children through this. One should try to overcome gender-based discrimination. Means we should wipe out such discrimination. The next generation, the present generation can. Now we are educated. Now we are educated. We can wipe out this gender discrimination. Already, we began the lesson social stratification. In that point, we discussed education and inequality and gender inequality. Now let's come to the main point, social stratification. Social stratification. Social stratification. The human society has continued the practice of classifying the people as superior, inferior, upper, lower, and assigning the differential roles. This is common frailties of this society. The common phenomena of this society, the human society has continued the practice of classifying people as superior, inferior, upper, lower, and assigning the differential roles and status in the society is called as social stratification. But you want to understand what social stratification is, you better to go through the characteristics of or the features of social stratification. Then only we can understand it better. Now we are going to see the features of social stratification. Features of, for example, what are the features of elephant? Generally we can say it has huge trunk, like that, a huge body, like the similarly the features. Likewise, if you understand the features, you will understand the stratification, social stratification better. Features of social stratification. See, social stratification is social in nature. Social stratification is universal. Social stratification is ancient. Social stratification exists in different ways. Now we are going to see step by step. Now the first feature is social stratification is social in nature. The stratification based on social recognition and importance. See, once again you understand this, stratification based on the social recognition, guruti suvike, and importance, mahatva, but not on any physical trait. Could you give any example for this? Yes. For example, a person's status is not fixed on the physical traits like height, beauty, strength, physical traits. These are called physical traits like height, beauty, strength. But it is based on education, income, profession, skill, and other social traits. This is one of the features of social stratification. The next one is social stratification is universal. It is found anywhere. If you go anywhere in the world, pan world, it is prevailing. It is universal. Thus we can say universal. See, social stratification is universal. Wherever human society exists, social stratification exists based on division of labor, profession, income, and other social traits. The social stratification is universal wherever human society exists, and social stratification exists based on the division of labor, profession, income, and social traits. social stratification. Thus, we can say social stratification is universal. It is from the since the beginning of the human society. Since the beginning of human society. Then third point is social stratification is ancient. It is ancient. Social stratification is ancient. The social stratification is in existence since the birth of human society. Already I mentioned in the point of universal also. Social stratification is found even in the nomadic society or tribal society as well as the modern civilized society. Thus we can say social stratification is ancient. Then fourth point, social stratification exists in different ways. It exists in different ways. Exists in different ways. How can you say social stratification exists in different ways? How can you say? We can say the social stratification exists in different names and different areas. For example, in ancient Rome, difference were there between plebeians and patricians. Plebeians and patricians. Similarly, in India, there were four groups of people: Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. This is based on Varna theory. This is based on Varna theory. Major forms of social stratification. Now we are going to see the major forms of social stratification. See, social stratification exists in different ways. How it was prevailing in Roman society, how it was prevailing in Indian society, how it was prevailing in Greek society. If you go and see, it was prevailing in the nomadic society, even in the tribal society. So it was called by different ways, and we can say it was existed in different ways. Now we are going to see major forms of social stratification. Major forms of social stratification. Dear children, now let's see the various forms of social stratification or major forms of social stratification. The social stratification is present in all the societies in the all the countries of the world. Their forms are not similar. Already you come to know that plebeians and patricians, Varna system. Similarly, it is different in the different way it is in existence. They have differences in their structure. They have differences in their nature. Now let us try to know the social stratification from the ancient world till the digital world. See, we are calling this is the digital world or advanced world. Are you believe or do you believe that still that Varna system existing? Still that social major social structure are prevailing? Now let us see primitive society. See, you know that there primitive society, major forms of social stratification. First one is primitive society. Primitive society. Second one is slavery. Slavery. Third one is estate system. What is this estate system? You might have heard only real estate, but this is something different. Estate system. Third one is fourth one is Varna system. Varna system. One minute. Varna system. And fifth one is caste system. Caste system. Okay. This is major forms of social system. My question is, note down the question. Mention the major forms of social stratification. which existing in various parts of the world. Once again, mention the major forms of social stratification which is existing in various countries of the world. Now, we are moving to see the very important part of this stratification, that is untouchability, social evil. Dear children, now we are moving to see the untouchability and social evil. In the beginning, the varna system was present in the Indian society. It is believed that it started during the Vedic period. Four varna system was there. There was four varna system of social division. And it is said that it is based on karma theory. See, this four varna system was in existence, was in practice, and still it is in practice. Still, that is, that varna system, it is said that it is based on karma. Based on karma theory. Karma theory. For example, Brahmana, which are the four varnas? Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Brahmana was confined to study, teaching and participation in yajnas. Brahmana was an authorized community to perform yajna, teaching and study in previous days, in Vedic times, but not now. And Kshatriyas, they were looking after political administration. Then Vaishyas, they are confined to business. Then Shudras, they were confined to manual labors. Once again, this is based on karma theory. Brahmana, he was confined to teaching and performing yajnas and study. Then Kshatriya, he was assigned to, means Kshatriya was to do political administration. Third one, Vaishya, he has to engage only in business. And Shudra, he has to perform manual labors. All these who belong to these four groups are expected to perform their respective roles. See, here Shudra should not indulge in teaching, conducting yajnas and study. Likewise, means here all the people who belong to these four groups are expected to perform their respective roles. Now we have discussed the four varnas and four groups. But another major group is there, that is fifth group. They are considered as panchamas. The fifth group, which were considered as untouchables. They were never considered as humans. See, these four varna, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Shudra, Vaishya, they have their respective roles to perform. But the fifth group, which were considered as untouchables, they were never considered as the humans. The practice of untouchability has its beginning in Varna system. See, untouchables, that you know that how they are treated. I am not going to discuss all those things in here. The issue of touchable and untouchable is related to profane. What do you mean by profane? See, this untouchability and touchability belong to the matter of profane and sacred ideas. What do you mean by profane? Here profane means unholy, worldly, apavitra, alaukika, ungodly. See, this is based on, see, this issue of touchable and untouchable is related to profane and sacred ideas based on inequality in socio-economic areas of life. See what a complex social factors. It is very, very complex fact, social practice, and very, very social division, complex division. The British government, after seeing this, British government through its India Government Act of 1935 classified the untouchables and tribal people as scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. Here these untouchables are called the Panchamas, the fifth group. They are never considered as the human beings. They should not come into the town or the village. They were always kept away from the villages. So they are means they are considered as the fifth group. Now let's see an analysis of why a group of people stayed outside the village, whether they came from outside or were pushed outside, provides an answer to the birth and practice of untouchability. Who says this? Who made this statement? An architect of Indian Constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar says, an analysis of why a group of people stayed outside of the village. Whether they come from outside or pushed outside. See, in that way he makes a statement about untouchability. Then the father of nation, Gandhiji, says untouchability is heinous expression of caste system. It is the hatefulest expression of the caste. See, now what was the opinion of untouchability according to Ambedkar? Note down the question. What was the opinion? And second one is, what did Gandhiji say about untouchability? Here Gandhiji says untouchability is heinous expression of caste system. Heinous. It is the hatefulest expression of caste. That you know that Ambedkar's fight to address this issue, untouchability, is notable. He is the redeemer on the part of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes and depressed classes and oppressed classes. He seems to be son on the part of these deprived classes and underprivileged classes. Now, once again, I'll ask some questions. Note down those questions. This is for homework as well as for Vidyagama. What did Ambedkar say about untouchability? First question. What did Ambedkar say about untouchability? The second question is, what is Gandhiji's view on untouchability? Which are the four Varnas? Who were considered as fifth group in Indian caste system? Which are the two groups prevailing in Roman society? Okay, dear children, today we discussed untouchability and its evil, then features of social stratification, gender inequality, that means, you know, gender bias. I hope you will go through the textbook and this video and note down all the questions and try to answer. Sairam.